Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. In today's video, a great game that Nepomniachtchi played just a couple of weeks ago at the Dortmund Sparkassen 2019. Nepomniachtchi with the white pieces against Nisipeanu, the strong German grandmaster with a rating of 2666, 2000 points more than the David, so this is a guy that we must fear. But Nepomniachtchi won't be scared. Black. So Nisipeanu will pay the Petrov using an idea that it's good to know and to understand. Let's get started. Nepomniachtchi with the white pieces opens with d4 and Nisipeanu answers with e5. Knight to f3, knight to f6, the Petrov defense, knight captures and d6. The knight moves back to f3, knight captures on e4 and here comes knight to c3. This is a modern way to fight the Petrov. After knight captures on c3 and d captures on c3, here comes bishop to e7 and almost always white plays bishop to e3 with the idea of queen to d2 and to castle down to start a kingside attack. Here comes short castle, queen to d2, and the main line in this position is to play knight in b goes to d7 with the idea to relocate the knight to f6. But Nisipeanu instead will use a different idea. Queen to e8, but what is the idea? Now, if white castles long, let's watch what happens in this variation. If white plays long castle, not what Nepomniachtchi played in the game, now this queen from e8 can move to a4 with tempo, attacking a2. Here comes king to b1 and knight to c6, h4 to start the kingside attack, but after bishop to e6, another piece attacking a2, here comes b3, queen back to a5, pinning and attacking c3, and black's idea is to stop white's attack on the kingside, giving problems to white on the queen side and in the center of the board as soon as possible. Now, knight to g5 doesn't work attacking the bishop, at least with the idea to gain the bishop pair, because here comes bishop to f6, the knight will move back to e4, bishop to e5 now with equality. This position, if white continues with the normal move, with the good idea f4, here comes d5, a push in the center, f captures, d captures, bishop to d4, and rook in a goes to d8, pinning the bishop, and white must lose other time. But Nepomniachtchi doesn't castle long after queen to e8, instead he continues with h4, and this is a novelty, the game is already original at move 9. Queen to a4 in any case, now of course, it's not possible to castle long or the queen will capture on a2. So here comes h5 and h6. Bishop to d3. Rook to e8, indirectly attacking the king. Now, if white castles short, then queen to g4 will win this pawn without compensation. So instead of playing short castle, that it's not a good idea in this position, Nepomniachtchi just continues with king to f1. Now bishop to f8, controlling a second time h5, knight to d4, and queen to d7. This is a mistake, because the queen is now blocking the action of the light square bishop that was controlling h3, and without this control of the bishop on h3, Nepomniachtchi can play rook to h3 with the idea of rook to g3 attacking the king. Very dangerous idea. Knight to c6, this is a move that good move but doesn't solve any problem, and rook to g3 pinning g7. Now Nisipeanu continues with king to h8, breaking the pin, and this is the best move. Let's go back one move. Knight captures on d4 doesn't work. In fact, here comes bishop captures on d4. There is still the idea of queen captures on h6, and king to g8 now doesn't break the pin, because the queen can still capture with check, of course winning the game, because is this bishop that will pin g7. So rook to e6 controlling h6, bishop to f5 seems to win the quality, but doesn't work because there is queen to b5 with check. But even if bishop to f5 doesn't work, after rook to e6 there is another move that works, f4 with the idea of f5. Now queen to d8, f5 wins the exchange, because if the rook moves back to e8, this move lose on the spot. Bishop captures, bishop captures, queen captures on h6, and checkmate will come. So after f4, of course, queen to d8, f5, rook to f6 is the only move to play, and the bishop will capture, and white is completely winning the game. So after rook to g3, good idea, the move that Nisipeanu played, king to h8, breaking the pin. Here comes knight captures on c6, and b captures on c6. Bishop to d4, now pinning g7, and of course there is the terrible threat, queen capture on h6. So rook to e6, queen to f4, now there is another checkmating idea, queen to f5, giving checkmate on h7. Black, of course, must try to stop this idea. So let's watch a good move. Let's watch what happens if now black continues with d5. Why d5? Because d5 is controlling e4. Now queen to f5 can be stopped by rook to e4, but here comes queen captures on d7, bishop captures, white will win the exchange and probably also the game. So that's why Nisipeanu doesn't play d5, but he tries to find an improvement of this idea. So let's go back. After queen to f4, instead of d5, he plays queen to e8. If now queen to f5, this move works, because there is rook to g6, the bishop is attacking the queen, and the rook is closing this diagonal, so the queen must move back to f3, and after rook captures on g3, or f captures, or queen captures, white is still better, but much of the attack is lost. But queen to e8 is not the improvement that black was looking for. Only queen to e7 improved a bit the d5 idea, and in some moves we will understand why. Nepomniachtchi, after queen to e8, can play a crushing move. Rook to e3, now attacking the strongest defender of black's position, and Nisipeanu resigns. Because what to do as black? Of course, this rook can't move away because the queen will be lost. Let's watch what happens if rook captures on e3, it's already checkmate in 2. The queen can capture on h6, we check, king to g8, queen to h7 is checkmate. So let's go back. After rook to e3, if king to g8, here comes queen to f5, and the checkmate threat is here on h7. g6 seems to solve some problems, but here comes rook captures on e6, and the best move, the move that would solve some problems, is bishop captures on e6. But this move, now that the queen is not on e7 controlling f6, doesn't work, because after bishop captures on e6 there is queen to f6 and nothing can stop the checkmate. So after g6 and rook captures on e6, queen captures on e6 is the best answer. But the white queen will move back to f3. Now rook to d1 is in the cards, and what to play as black? So let's try bishop to g7. Here comes rook to e1 against the queen, queen back to d7, h captures, f captures, rook to e3. Now this bishop can't move, because with the help of the queen they are protecting f5. So rook to b8, a bit useless, but is the only move that, or one of the only moves that black can play. But here comes queen to e2, and nothing can stop the rook's invasion. Even bishop captures on d4 doesn't work because rook to e8 we check, king to g7, rook to e7 we check, we win the queen and also the game. So it was a short but nice attacking game by Nepomniachtchi against one idea in the Petrov that was new to me, but that now we know and understand. I hope that you liked the video. I will prepare other nice games to show you while we are waiting for the important Cinquefield Cup that we start just in few days in St. Louis. Our video is over. I thank you very much for watching and see you tomorrow. Goodbye!